Good morning everyone. In this video, we learn how to solve a constraint minimization problem with the help of Lagrange multiplier method. Here, we take a cost minimization problem. Question is, minimize cost of a farm with the cost function C is equal to 8L plus twice K subject to the production quota Q is equal to twice L to the power 1 by 3 K to the power 2 by 3 equal to 64 and also find minimum cost. Solution. The cost function is given by C is equal to 8L plus twice K. The production quota is Q is equal to twice L to the power 1 by 3, K to the power 2 by 3 equal to 64. In order to minimize cost function, C is equal to 8L plus twice K subject to production quota Q is equal to twice L to the power 1 by 3 K to the power 2 by 3 equal to 64. We first construct the Lagrange function such that Z equal to 8L plus twice K plus lambda 64 minus twice L to the power 1 by 3 K to the power 2 by 3. So this is equation 1. We have to minimize this Z function. The first order condition for cost minimization requires ZL, that is partial derivative of Z with respect to L equal to 0. ZK, that is partial derivative of Z with respect to K is equal to 0. And Z lambda equal to partial derivative of Z with respect to lambda equal to 0. The second order condition requires that second order border Hessian determinant of the element 0, ZL, ZK, ZL, ZLL, ZLK, ZK, ZKL, ZKK. Now, ZL, that is partial derivative of Z with respect to L, del by del L, put the value of Z, that is 8L plus twice K plus lambda multiplied by 64 minus twice L to the power 1 by 3 K to the power 2 by 3. The derivative value is partial derivative of 8L is 8, partial derivative of twice K is 0, partial derivative of this 64 is 0, so partial derivative of minus 2L 1 by 3 K to the power 1 by 2 by 3 is minus lambda 1 by 3, that is the power of L which comes before it, 2 L 1 by 3 power 1 minus 1, sorry 1 by 3 minus 1, K to the power 2 by 3, that is equal to 8 minus lambda 1 by 3 twice L 1 power 1 by 3, K to the power 2 by 3 divided by L. This divided by L because of this power minus 1. That is equal to ZQ by ZL, that is twice L 1 by 3 power 1 by 3 K to the power 1 by 3 is equal to Q. So here ZQ twice L divided by twice L equal to 8. That means lambda is equal to 24L by Q, that is equation number 2. Similarly, ZK is a partial derivative of z with respect to k, which equal to 0, which must be equal to 0. So del by del k, put the value of z. So this is the value of z. Taking derivative of it, we get, see, a l is a constant, so it is 0. So partial derivative of twice k is 2. So partial derivative of this portion is minus lambda 2 by 3, that is a power of k, 2 l power 1 by 3, k to the power 2 by 3 minus 1. That is equal to 2 minus lambda 2 by 3, 2 to the power 2, sorry, 2 by 3, 2 l power 1 by 3, k to the power 2 by 3 divided by k. So this k is because of this minus 1. Equal to lambda 2q divided by twice k is equal to 2, and that is equal to lambda is equal to 3k divided by q. Z lambda is the partial derivative of z with respect to lambda. So del by del lambda, put the value of z, this is the value of z. So derivative value of this is 64 minus twice l to the power 1 by 3 k to the power 2 by 3 is equal to 0. That is equation number 4. From equation 2 and 3 we get lambda is equal to 24 l by q and equal to twice k by q. That is equal to twice k equal to 24L. Therefore, k is equal to 8L. Substituting the value of k equal to 8L in equation 4, we get, put the value of k equal to 8L in equation 4. So, 64 minus twice L to the power 1 by 3, and in place of k, we write 8L to the power 2 by 3 equal to 0. After simplification, we get twice L power 2 by 3, 8 to the power 2 by 3, L to the power 2 by 3 is equal to 64. So L, twice L to the power, we have 2 L here, 1 L is, power of 1 L is 1 by 3 and another is 2 by 3. So we have to add up the edit the powers. So l to the power 1 by 3 plus 2 by 3, and this 8 power 2 by 3 is converted as this 2 to the power cube multiplied by 2 by 3 equal to 64. After simplification, we get twice l to the power 1 plus 2 by 3 and 2 square, because this 3 will cancel, ultimately we'll get 2 square equal to 64. So that is equal to twice L4. So power of L becomes 1. So L, so 2 square is 4. So 2L4 is equal to 64. Therefore L is equal to 8. Therefore you put the value of L in this relation, we get K is equal to 8L. That is equal to 8 multiplied by 8 is equal to 64. So it is a value of k. Again, del, so zll, that is second order partial derivative of z with respect to l. So del square by z, del square z by del l square. So del by del l, put the value this. Already we have got in the first order derivative, in the first order condition, that is 8 minus lambda 1 by 3 twice L power 1 by 3 minus 1 k to the power 2 by 3. See, what is the derivative value? So 8 is constant, that is 0, minus lambda 1 by 3 is here. So this 1 by 3 minus 1, this is the power of L, so it comes here. 2 to the power 2 2 L to the power 1 by 3 minus 1 and minus 1 K to the power 2 by 3 minus 1 1 by 3. So after deducting 1 by 1 from 1 1 by 3 we'll get minus 2 by 3. So L 1 by L square, so the, because of this minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2, so it will come into denominator twice L 1 by 3 K to the power 2 by 3. So that is equal to twice lambda by 3 into 3 9, yes, minus minus plus, so this is, that is twice lambda 1 divided by L square, or this is a Q. And that is equal to twice lambda Q by 9 L square. ZLK, that is partial derivative, second order partial derivative of Z with respect to L and K. So that is equal to this. After differentiating, we get minus lambda 1 by 3, 2 by 3, L to the power, sorry, twice L to the power 1 by 3 minus 1 and K to the power 2 by 3 minus 1. So this 2 by 3 is a power of K. Equal to twice lambda by 9, so 3 is a 9, 1 by LK, because of this minus 1 and this minus 1, we write L and K in denominator. So twice L to the power 1 by 3, K to the power 2 by 3. That is equal to minus twice lambda Q divided by 9 LK, and that is equal to ZKL, that is partial derivative, second order partial derivative of Z with respect to K and L. ZKK, that is second order partial derivative of Z with respect to K. Put the value, that is 2 minus Z. 2 minus lambda 2 by 3 twice L to the power 1 by 3 K to the power 2 by 3 minus 1. So this is the derivative value, this is a constant, 0 minus lambda 2 by 3, so 2 by 3 minus 2, that is the power of K, 2 L power 1 by 3 K to the power 2 by 3 minus 1 minus 1. So that will, this will, this becomes minus lambda 2 by 3 minus 1 by minus 1 by 3. After deducting 1 from 2 by 3, we get this 1 by k to k square. So this k square, because of minus 1 minus and this minus 2, that's why it is, it comes into the denominator, 2 L to the power 1 by 3 K to the power 2 by 3. So this become twice lambda Q divided by 9k square. Now put this information in the second order border Hessian determinant, that is the h2 bar, where we have 0 zl zk zl zll zlk zk zkl zkk. Put the value, so 0 minus Z, that is the coefficient of L from the cost function, of the cost function, and minus 2, that is the coefficient of K of the cost function. We have put here, we have put it here. So ZLL is equal to this, ZLK is equal to this, ZKL equal to this, ZKK is equal to this. So find the value of this determinant. First is 0, is a minus, and minus it multiply 8 into this, so 16 lambda Q by 9k square minus 2 multiplied by this, so minus minus plus, to 4 lambda Q divided by 9 LK. Minus 2, that is minus 2, multiply these two, so 8 to the 16 lambda Q by 9 LK plus this 2, 2 to the 4 lambda cube divided by 9 L square. So that is equal to minus minus plus. So 8 16 is 128 is minus, so that is why minus lambda q by 9 k square minus 8 4 is 32 lambda q divided by 9 l k minus again multiply it 2 16 is 32 lambda q divided by 9 l k minus 2 4 is 8 lambda q my divided by 9 l square. See l k q lambda all are positive, but here we have all the negative sign, that is why it is less than 0. Here we have got the border Hessian determinant, second order border Hessian determinant value is negative, that is why the second order condition is satisfied. Therefore the cost minimizing output levels are L is equal to 8 and K is equal to 64, and minimum cost is, put the values of L and K in cost function, that is C is equal to 8L plus twice K, that is 8 into 8 plus 2 into 64, ultimately it becomes 192, the minimum cost is 192. So that's all about the solution of this problem. Thank you.